With our new performance and efficient cores, you have seen the details of one of the biggest advancements in x86 architecture in over a decade. So let's put that in context. We have shown you this roadmap of coves and months in the past. You may have noticed we have changed our nomenclature since. Our months were designed for the best area-efficient multi-threaded performance. Our cores were designed for maximum single-threaded performance. Now, while efficient core truly excels in throughput efficiency, it's also getting a boost in single-threaded performance. And the performance core is not only pushing the limits of low latency and single-threaded performance, it's also getting a boost in multi-threaded performance with additional AI acceleration. But where we want to be is here, where we can combine the best of both. Best of both in one system to get the raw performance of the P core with the scalability of the E core. We need a very high performance hybrid. Talking about hybrid, everyone understands the idea of the hybrid car as using hybrid technology to get the most miles out of a tank of gas. And that's a good analogy for the conventional notion of hybrid computing, getting the most hours out of a battery. But there is another type of automotive hybrid. The fastest racing cars in the world, like in Formula One, use hybrid technology to achieve maximum performance. In addition to the conventional turbocharged engines that give them top speed and enough range to make it to the finish line on a tank of fuel, they add electric power to blast them out of the corners with acceleration that cannot be achieved with conventional engines. We need a high-performance hybrid. The biggest challenge, the magic, is to bring these two cores together, working efficiently with existing software. This is a huge undertaking, and we have been hard at work on this problem for years. We now have the solution. To share more, I would like to invite our client architect, Rajshree.
Thanks, Raja, and hello, everyone. I'm really excited to share with you a unique solution we have developed to ensure two new cores you just heard about, efficient core and performance core, work seamlessly together so we can maximize system performance and efficiency. As we all know, performance expectation can vary drastically for different computing tasks. So one of the most important considerations we had while designing our next generation client CPU SoC was ensuring optimal task scheduling across two different core types. The challenges given to the team were, first, how do we go beyond traditional hybrid as we know it? And second, how do we get both core types to work together intelligently to maximize performance? As Raja mentioned, we could have taken conventional approach of simply assigning threads to cores based on static rules. But that leaves a lot of performance on the table and creates overhead with software development. Our solution needed to be dynamic and autonomous to software stack that is running on top. So we decided to help OS make more intelligent decisions. It is needed to handle a wide range of common client activities such as gaming with streaming, content creation, productivity, while dynamically adapting to operating conditions such as temperature and power budget. We also wanted to eliminate the need for software developers to having to rewrite their existing code and remove overhead of handling scheduling tasks in software. Only a hardware solution could meet all these requirements. So we developed Intel Thread Director technology. Thread Director technology is one of the most significant and exciting innovations in our client roadmap. Thread Director technology allows us to provide smarter assistance to the OS by monitoring instruction mix, current state of each core, and relevant microarchitecture telemetry at a granular level. This also allows OS to utilize information it didn't previously have any visibility into at time of making its scheduling decisions. By implementing Intel Thread Director in hardware, we are able to keep advantage of our performance monitoring unit, which provides the best hardware telemetry in the industry. Access to this information allows Intel Thread Director to assist OS in optimal runtime scheduling. Traditionally, OS would have made decisions based on limited information that was available, such as foreground versus background. Thread Director adds a new dimension to the hardware telemetry, So threads with higher performance requirements are assigned to most performant cores. Let's walk through a scheduling example on a real scenario. Let's say a user starts a performance critical task such as a game or a content creation software. Those threads first will be assigned to our performance cores. Now, if a background task such as, you know, email sync or network drive backup starts, those lower priority, less demanding tasks will go to our efficient cores. Next, let's assume a case where all the performant cores are busy, but a thread needing even higher performance becomes ready, such as an AI thread using CPU AI instruction. In this situation, thread director provides what we refer to as a hint to the OS, indicating there's a higher performance thread needing attention. Thread director also identifies a candidate thread that could be moved from performance cores to efficient cores based on relative performance ordering, making room for that AI thread. This is where the dynamic nature of our innovation shines. Nothing is static based on any software. Everything is dynamic based on the current context of whatever is running on the system, all augmented by hardware telemetry. And last, if a thread running on performance core enters a spinning state, you know, waiting for work to show up, then thread director reports this situation back to OS. This thread will be moved over to an E core, thereby making room for a more performant thread to be allocated to our performance cores. This is our animation explanation of the technology. Let's see it in action on Alder Lake, running Windows 11, incorporating thread director feedback in real time. In typical cases, we see combination of scalar and vector instruction, mix of important and background tasks. We are going to see how thread director helps OS with placement of these threads. In the first example, we have a representation of a typical media content creation usage we see with real-world software. The green threads that you are seeing here are mostly scalar instruction. The dark blue threads that you see are vector instructions, and the light blue are background tasks. The vector instructions, for the most part, get prioritized on performance cores, as they require more performance, while some of the green threads and the light blue thread go to efficient cores. Let's look at one more example, this time with office productivity and background application. Office productivity, video conferencing, CPU AI instruction usage in these cases is increasing consistently. Placement of these AI threads is going to be key to maximize performance. As we have seen with previous example, we have green threads, which are mostly scalar. Then we have the orange AI threads added to the mix, where you can see thread director prioritizes them to performance cores. As seen before, the light blue tasks are running on efficient cores. All these threads here in this mix go through various phases within their own execution. You might have noticed there are phases once in a while where the dark blue vector threads or the orange AI thread go to E cores. These are the phases where they have some scalar instructions in them. This is where the dynamic nature of this technology, prioritizing right thread to right core based on current execution context, comes in. Lastly, I do want to show something else. I want to show fully multi-threaded synthetic workload running same instruction mix. Here, all threads go use all available core. To enable this level of fine-grained coordination for real performance, Intel jointly worked with Microsoft to incorporate this revolutionary capability into upcoming Windows 11 release. Speaking of which, I would like to invite Mehmet Iyigun from Microsoft to share more details.
Hello. Throughout the Windows 11 development cycle, my team has been working with our colleagues at Intel to enlighten and optimize our upcoming OS to take full advantage of the performance hybrid architecture and Thread Director in particular. Much of this work centers around the OS thread scheduler, the kernel component that decides which threads to run and where to run them. These decisions have a huge impact on user perceived performance and power consumption, especially on devices built on hybrid processor architectures. To make its decisions, the scheduler considers attributes such as thread priority, the owning application, and whether the application is foreground or background. For example, threads belonging to foreground applications should be scheduled to high-performance cores. However, up until now, the scheduler had no visibility into the workload running on a thread, whether it's copying memory, spinning in a loop, or performing complex calculations. As such, when demand for high-performance cores exceeded supply, it made suboptimal decisions because it couldn't identify the workloads that would benefit most from the performance cores. Thread Director helps close this gap. With Thread Director feedback, the Windows 11 thread scheduler is much smarter about dynamically picking the most appropriate core based on the workload to achieve the best power and performance. Even when all P cores are busy, it can preempt a thread running on a P core to swap it with a thread running on an E core if the latter can benefit more from the P core. The scheduler, of course, does this without violating any of its priority-based fairness guarantees. Beyond thread scheduling, Windows 11 also uses Thread Director hints when deciding which cores to park and unpark for power savings. For example, if all outstanding work targets E cores, the system can refrain from unparking a P core. In addition to automatic workload classification provided by Thread Director, Windows 11 also extends the Power Throttling API, which allows developers to explicitly specify quality of service attributes for their threads. The new EcoQoS classification informs the scheduler that the thread prefers power efficiency over performance. Such threads get scheduled on E cores, reducing power consumption and leaving the P cores available for performance critical threads. The Edge browser, as well as various Windows 11 components, now take advantage of the EcoQoS API to boost energy efficiency. This was a short summary of the improvements we put into Windows 11 in collaboration with multiple teams at Microsoft and Intel. There are many more optimizations I did not talk about and many more in planning stages. What is clear is that we're at an inflection point in heterogeneous computing, and we're going to continue seeing tighter integration and information exchange between hardware and the OS to unleash further performance and better life improvements. I'm looking forward to continuing our collaboration with Intel. Thank you.
We are very excited about the performance benefits of this technology and the potential it holds for future innovation. With that, I would like to hand it over to my colleague, Arik Gihon, to give you more details about Alder Lake SoC. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. I'm very excited to introduce Alder Lake today. Intel's new client architecture on Intel's 7 process that scales from the highest performance enthusiast desktop to the thinnest, most responsive Evo laptops. Alder Lake is Intel's first performance hybrid core design, introducing two core types brought together seamlessly through Intel Thread Director technology. Alder Lake supports the latest state-of-the-art industry standards in memory, I/O, and connectivity for no compromise PC experience. Let's get to know Alder Lake. Alder Lake was built for performance. We started with desktop architecture and scaled all the way down to ultra mobile. One of our most important goals when designing Alder Lake was to support all client segments through a single, highly scalable SoC architecture with three design points. First, a maximum performance two-chip socketed desktop with leadership performance, power efficiency, memory, and I/O. Second, a high-performance mobile BGA package that adds imaging, larger Xe graphics, and Thunderbolt 4 connectivity. And finally, a thin, lower power, high density package with optimized I/O and power delivery. Supporting this huge range of power and performance is an incredible silicon design challenge. Designing Alder Lake was an amazing technical journey for me, and I would like to share with you how we achieved it. Alder Lake architecture is built from a selection of world class IPs for die level configurability. We enabled multiple combinations of performance cores and efficient cores, a large number of I/Os and accelerators, various levels of Xe graphics, and 4 different memory types. Both P cores and E cores are built as interchangeable slices that include a portion of the last level cache, allowing us to build multiple die topologies spanning Alder Lake's huge design range. The accelerators and I/Os are connected through an hierarchical structure configured to support the required bus width, queue sizes, number of ports, and memory access feature set. Alder Lake leverages the Xe LP graphics from Tiger Lake, ported to Intel 7. it supports 1080p gameplay and 12-bit end-to-end video pipeline. Finally, the memory subsystem is designed in tiles to cope efficiently with the large required bandwidth range, memory encryption, integrity, and multiple DDR technologies. Let's take a deeper look at each of the key technologies. Everything starts with the new performance hybrid architecture. We use up to 8 high single-thread performance cores and up to 8 efficient cores, both supporting high dynamic frequency range and per-core power states. The E-cores are clustered with a shared L2 cache and deliver scalable multi-thread performance and efficient offload of background tasks. The last-level cache has a shared structure between the cores and graphics that provides higher effective cache size on a lightly threaded load. For controlling the operation of this massive compute, we have developed an autonomous power management scheme. This controls the various cores to optimize performance per watt according to software and platform preferences. As we saw in the demo, all of this is orchestrated by the thread director for proper workload scheduling. We develop a sophisticated hardware runtime mechanism that identifies the class of each workload. The class, together with the energy and performance core scoring mechanism, guides the OS to schedule threads on the right core for performance or efficiency per demand. Let me show you the memory capabilities. Alder Lake delivers a separate set of DDR technologies with Intel's unique PHY, supporting DDR4 and DDR5, as well as LPDDR4 and LPDDR5 in a single chip, leading the industry to this major memory transition. Alder Lake supports high-frequency DDR speeds and can alter the speed based on runtime bandwidth requirements while tracking the workload behavior. This allowed high-speed, high-power, or low-speed, low-power operations based on real-time heuristics. If you think this is cool, we also upgraded our PCIe capabilities. Alder Lake is leading the transition to PCIe Gen 5 with up to twice the bandwidth of Gen 4. It supports up to 16 lanes and reaches 64 gigabytes per second, ready for the next generation of SSDs and discrete graphics. So let's see how all of this works together. The challenge of building such a highly scalable architecture is that we need to meet the incredible bandwidth demands of the compute and I/O agents without compromising on power. To solve this challenge, we have designed 3 independent fabrics, each with real-time demand-based heuristics. While the workload is running, the power management unit collects telemetry from the fabric sources, track the traffic, and select the most efficient work point. The compute fabric can support up to 1,000 gigabytes per second, which is 100 gigabytes per second per core or per cluster. It connects the cores and graphics through the last level cache to the memory. It has high dynamic frequency range, and it's capable of dynamically selecting the data path for latency versus bandwidth optimization based on actual fabric loads. It also dynamically adjusts the last level cache policy, inclusive or non-inclusive, based on utilization. The I/O fabric supports up to 64 gigabytes per second and connects the different types of I/Os as well as internal devices. It can change speed seamlessly without interfering with device's normal operation, selecting the fabric speed to match the required amount of data transfer. And last, the memory fabric can deliver up to 204 gigabytes of data. It dynamically scales its bus width and speed to support multiple operating points for high bandwidth, low latency, or low power. This real-time scaling enables Alder Lake to take dynamically shift the power budget to where it matters the most. Finally, I'm working with the team on Alder Lake in the lab now, and I can't wait to have one at home.